Hello friends, yesterday we discussed about two applications of total internal reflection. First, mirage, and second we discuss about diamond, right? Now today we will discuss about another two application of total internal reflection. So we already know there are four applications of total internal reflection: mirage, diamond, prism, and last one is optical fiber. We already discussed about mirage and diamond. Today we will discuss about prism and optical fiber, right? So first of all, we starting with prism. So prism are designed to bend light by 90 degree or 180 degree to make use of the total internal reflection, right? You can see in this figure here, we already discussed that prism designed to bend light by 90 degree or 180 degree to make use of total internal reflection as shown in figure A and figure B. Here you can see this is prism, right? Here we bend light by 90 degree. You can see in this figure for A, see here, this is incident ray, incident at this surface, and after reflection it is passes like this. For B, same. So here the light is bent by 90 degree, but here in this case the critical angle is much less than 45 degree. So here you have to remember that, okay, in prism the critical angle must be less than 45 degree, right? We know that if our angle of incident is greater than critical angle, then total internal reflection occurs. So here the critical angle is less than 45, so total internal reflection occurs, right? See here, this is 90 degree bend. Here in this figure B, bend light by 180 degree. You can see in this figure, this is ray B like this, incident on this surface like this, for A like this. So here the bend by 180 degree. So you can see here, this is 90 degree and this is also 90 degree. So 90 plus 90, 180. For A, you can see 90, 90, 180, right? So here 180 degree bend occurs, right? So we can say that prisms are designed to be bent light by 90 degree or by 180 degree to make use of total internal reflection. Here in this case, the critical angle for the material of prism must be less than 45 degree, right? So if you want to bend light by 90 degree or 180 degree, you have to use the material of prism having critical angle less than 45 degree, right? Okay, one another use is such a prism is used to invert the image without changing their size, right? So here you have to remember that if we want to invert image without changing their size, then we use the prism. Okay, so this is the topic used for MCQ, right? You have to remember that prisms are designed to be bent light by 90 or 180 degree. If you want to bend light by 90 or 180 degree, you have to use material of prism must be less than 45 degree of critical angle. And prism is used to invert image without changing their size. Here you can see that such a prism is used to invert image without changing their size. Right? Okay. So this is for the prism. Okay. So now our last application of total internal reflection is optical fiber. Right? So optical fiber is designed to use of the phenomena of total internal reflection. It is made or fabricated with high quality of glass or quartz. You have to remember that optical fiber is to make use of the phenomena of total internal reflection. This optical fiber is fabricated with high quality of glass or quartz. Here each fiber consists core and cladding. You know about core, and cladding is the surrounded surface, outer side of the core. Okay, so optical fiber consists of core and cladding. Now the refractive index of the material of core is higher than that of cladding. You have to remember this thing, that the refractive index of core is higher than the cladding. So you have to remember this. Okay, once again I repeat, optical fiber is to make a use of phenomena of total internal reflection. It is made with glass or quartz. Each fiber consists core and the cladding. What is cladding? So cladding is the outer side part of the core. The refractive index of core is higher than cladding. You have to remember, right? Okay, now the question is, what is the function of optical fiber? The function is, when a signal in the form of light is directed at one end of the fiber at a suitable angle, it undergoes repeated total internal reflection along the length of fiber and finally comes out at the other end. You can see here the function: when a signal in form of light is directed at one end of the fiber at a suitable angle, it undergoes repeated total internal reflection along the length of the fiber, finally comes out at the other end. You can see here in this figure, this is the figure of optical fiber, right? You can see here, this is the core and this outer side is known as cladding. We know that core has higher reflective index and the cladding has lower reflective index. So here you can see that high N, which means higher refractive index, and cladding has lower end, so lower reflective index, right? So see here, this is our light of ray of light, you can see, or we can say only light. This is our light. Now this light enters in the fiber at some suitable angle. We know that angle of incident, this is our incident ray and normal, so this is angle of incident. Now Here, the light is directed at one end with some suitable angle. We don't deal with angle, but here something angle is there. Now, it enters the core. We know that if the ray of light went from rarer to denser medium, then it bends towards normal. And if a ray of light went from denser medium to rarer medium, then it moves away from the normal, right? So here, after the diffraction, the ray of light passes like this. Now here, a light incident at some angle, and this angle is greater than the critical angle. So here total internal reflection occurs. After total internal reflection, this light is reflected in this same medium. You can see this. Now this optical fiber is fabricated such that the light reflected one side of the inner surface strikes the another surface here at angle larger than the critical angle. So again total internal reflection occurs. So this process is continue, and at last the light finally comes out at the another end. Once again I repeat, this is the figure of optical fiber, this is core, this is outer side known as cladding. You have to remember that core has higher reflective index than cladding. So here higher reflective index and cladding has lower reflective index. Now here light incident at some angle. Now the ray of light enters into the core, but this optical fiber is fabricated such that when the light incident in the surface has angle larger than the critical angle, then total internal reflection occurs. So the light reflected in the same medium, we can say that in the core, like this. And this optical fiber are fabricated such that light reflected at one side of inner surface strike the other surface here at angle larger than the critical angle. So again total internal reflection occurs. So this process is continue, and final the light comes out at the another end. Now here you can see the design of optical fiber like this. So the fiber is bent, light can easily travel along its length, right? This optical fiber can be used to act as a optical pipe because it travels the light. So we can say that optical fiber can be used to act as an optical pipe, right? Now you have to remember one device which is known as transducer. So this transducer is the device which convert one form of energy to another form. So you have to remember, a device which converts one form of energy into the another form of energy is known as transducer. So you have to remember that we use transducer to convert the form of energy. right? Now, these optical fiber are used for transmit or receiving the electrical signal. Now, question arises in your mind, how we can get electrical signal? So we already know this light can be converted to signal by the use of transducer, right? Because we discussed that transducer is the device which is used to convert one form of energy into the another form, right? So we can use optical fiber for transmit or receive the electrical signal. We can also use optical fiber for transmission of the optical signal, right? Or we can also use in decorative lamps. So these are the use of optical fiber. I repeat, we use optical fiber to transmit or receive the electrical signal. It also be used for transmission of optical signal, and it is used for the decorative lamps. Another use of optical fiber is it can be used as a light pipe to facilitate the examination of our internal organs like stomach and intestines. So we can also use optical fiber as a light pipe to examine our internal organs, right? Now here total internal reflection at each stage occurs in a such that no appreciable loss in intensity of the light signal. So this is the advantage, that there will be a no loss of intensity of the light signal. But the main requirement is fabricating the optical fiber is that there should be very little absorption of light, because here we have to transmit the light long way. So we have to design optical fiber such that there will be very less absorption of the light. So this can be achieved by purification and special preparation of material such as quartz. So if we want to travel a light for a long distance, so we have to fabricate optical fiber such that there will be a very less absorption of light. So this is done through the purification and special preparation of the material like glass or quartz. And in last point, silica glass optical fiber. This is the one type of optical fiber, silica glass fiber. With use of silica glass fiber, it is possible to transmit more than 95% of the light over a fiber length of 1 kilometer. So with the use of silica glass fiber, we can transmit the light more than 95% over the length of 1 kilometer, right? So here I write the all things. Once again, I read it. See here. Optical fiber to make a use of the phenomena of the total internal reflection. It is fabricated with high quality composite glass or quartz. Each fiber consists of core and cladding. The reflective index of the material of core is higher than that of cladding. Now, what is the function? So the function is, when a signal in form of light is directed at one end of the fiber at a suitable angle, it undergoes repeated total internal reflection along the length of fiber and comes out at the other end. You can see in this figure, right? This is core, higher reflective index, cladding lower, and in final the ray of light comes out of at the another end. Now, since the light undergoes total internal reflection at each stage, there is no appreciable loss in intensity of the light signal. So here there will be no loss of intensity. Optical fibers are fabricated such that light reflected at one side of the inner surface strikes the other at an angle larger than the critical angle. So here total internal reflection occurs. Now, even if the fiber is bent, light can easily travel along its length. We can already discuss that. Here the fiber is bent, so light can easily travel along its length. Thus, optical fiber can be used to act as an optical pipe. A bundle of optical fiber can be put to several uses. We can use the bundle of optical fibers. The device which convert one form of energy into the another form of energy is called transducer. Optical fiber are extensively used for transmitting and receiving the electrical signals, which are converted to light by a suitable transducer. Right, we know that transducer converts one form of energy into the another form of energy. They also use for transmission of the optical signals, right? For example, these are used as light pipe to facilitate visual examination of our internal organs like stomach or instances. The fibers is such that are used for decorative lamps. The main requirement is fabricating optical fiber is that there should be very little absorption of light as it travels for a long distance. So this is achieved by the purification and special preparation of the material such as quartz, right? And in our last point, in silica glass fiber, it is possible to transmit more than 95% of the light over a fiber length of 1 kilometer. So this is about optical fiber, right? So this theory is very useful for us, or it can be asked in 2 or 3 marks, right? Explain the principle of optical fiber or explain optical fiber. Okay, thank you.